Hell y'all, this is the Old World Blues mod for Hearts of Iron 4, a mod which takes place in the Fallout universe. I am running it with a submod called Old World Blues Cuba, which adds the nation of Cuba and a focus tree for it. The country we are going to be playing as starts off led by Gerardo Perez, and besides that, the ruling ideology is the people. We start with one national spirit, and it is called Cuban Ingenuity. It gives us a very high trade deal opinion factor buff, as well as an insane level of diplomacy distance. Looking at our military next, Army starts off with 3 divisions, and we do have a Navy which consists of 4 ships, one of them being a strike craft, and the rest are assault crafts. Judging by the icons they use, I think individually a strike craft is stronger than a assault craft. Now for technology, we have basic weaponry, basic melee weapons, special forces equipment, scrap motorcycles, scrap gun trucks, and most of the starting tech for anything vaguely related to naval combat. Let's begin the focus tree with 3 focuses that will give us events, and these focuses are Cuban genericness, the Great War, and place in the New World. Cuban the generic. We can either focus on the military industry or industry itself. We are going to select the latter because it will give us civilian factories / workshops. Cuba was under American occupation prior to the Great War. Let's say during the occupation, the invaders focused on spamming divisions so they wouldn't need to invade again. This choice will decrease the amount of time it takes to construct military factories. How did Cuba recover after the war? We have 2 options here. Let's go with the one on the right that says production-based economy. With the 3 initial focuses completed, we will now do political effort, collectivist ethos, ruler focus, militarism, military youth, and only the strongest will rule Cuba. As an island nation, we are in a unique position to expand into the North American mainland. We will start this little adventure by justifying on the Bayou Motors country, which is based in what would have been considered part of the U.S. state of Louisiana prior to the nuclear apocalypse. Cuba falls as the government made contact with a quote American patrol and led them to the country under the pretext of them sharing their knowledge with us. The commander of this group, though apathetic about his mission, ordered the full occupation of the state. This all happened despite the nation's recent rapid militarization, but ultimately little could be done when the enemy was already at our throat. With all that said, the Enclave are here. Due to the recent change in leadership, we have unlocked a good amount of relatively advanced technology, including 2 but not limited to power armor, advanced servos, and plasma rifles. Cuba has transformed into the Cubaclave. We got a new flag, the guy in charge is Lieutenant Springfield, and now the ruling ideology is the ruler. Lieutenant Springfield, though an original character, he does have his own leadership trait called Apathetic Invader and his own little backstory. His story basically goes he was essentially exiled after questioning the president's policy on baseball. He was then sent off with a small group of soldiers to find the legendary Cuba. He did locate Cuba, obviously, but at the same time, he learned that it was in fact an island and not a place in Mexico. For some little info on the Enclave, in Fallout, it is a state-like entity that claims it is the successor to the United States of America, formed by political elites and prominent individuals before the Great War as a means to continue government continuity, and with its bases scattered all over the former U.S., it is a force to be reckoned with. Often hostile to outsiders, the Enclave is not afraid to use forceful means to accomplish its goals. On top of the takeover of Cuba by the Enclave, we also got 2 Cuban expedition units who are equipped with power armor and plasma weapons. More focuses, let's complete indirect control technology sharing, industrial effort, construction effort, armament effort, construction effort 2, armament effort 2, and then we'll just do whatever we want after that. In case you're wondering what's going on the mainland, some war started out west, a super mutant nation lost a civil war, and Lone Star is currently fighting the Hand Warband. Once we take out Bayou Motors, we are going to push inward by justifying a war goal on the patrolmen. Our soldiers have started making landfall on enemy-owned territory. All it should take to win this war is securing the cannery. The opponent's capital has fallen to the Cubiclave. They will surrender any moment now. With that war over, Bayou Motors has been made into a puppet. While it would have been nice to annex them outright, we need all the manpower we can get. In an area not too far away from us, relatively speaking, the Brotherhood of Steel Alamo chapter has started clashing with the pursuant. Slightly above us, to the northwest, the Carthaginian's raider gang is getting beat up by the Texan Brotherhood and their allies. The Yucatan Peninsula-centered Chichen Itza nation has declared war on La Tierra de los Tzotzil. Due to the path we took for Cuba, besides the whole takeover and everything, we got a special enclave cultural advisor named Corporal Porkins. In what could be considered former Mexico, the Ejército Mexicano has gotten itself into a conflict with Petro Chico. The main nation we have to worry about as we expand is the Texan Brotherhood, who can possibly interact with many of the countries we will most likely try to invade and liberate for the enclave. Petro Chico fell to the Ejército, and the Texan Brotherhood is destroying the Desperados. We have started our attack on the patrolmen. We brought in some Bayou Motors units to supplement our offensive, but even with their help or not, we should win because we have power armor. Like we did with the place that has the cannery, we are going to make the patrolmen into a puppet of the Cubiclave. Continuing with our plans for expansion, a war goal justification has been started for the Gator Moles. I've just discovered that for our military high command, we can select some people that are references to historical Cuban figures, such as Fidel Castro and the much more obscure Juan Blas Hernandez. The war goal for the Moles is ready. Let's make sure to call on our allies to help us, because we have no direct border connection to a soon-to-be enemy country. Our current commander has done a good job, but he doesn't fit our needs anymore, so we're going to replace him with either Sergeant Williams or Corporal Porkins, who we have as unit leaders. Besides that, Lieutenant Springfield, the leader of the Cubiclave, is available as a commanding officer, which in Old World Blues is essentially like a field marshal in vanilla Hoi 4. The opposing forces are occupied by our all-out assault on their front line, so while that is going on, we are going to maneuver some troops into their capital, Alexandria. While we are still in a war, which is going to be over soon, it appears that the Alamo chapter is in a vulnerable position as they are taking on the Ejército Mexicano. With all that in mind, once we have enough political power, we will justify on the Alamo chapter. We are going to use naval invasions to hit the Alamo BOS by surprise, which won't be much of an issue, considering I think we have the largest navy in the Gulf of Mexico. Cubiclave forces successfully land in and around Port Lavaca, a place when translated to Spanish literally means pork cow. Cuba's experiences with locations named after farm animals aside, we still need to actually capture a port, which we will do by attacking a nearby garrison from behind. With a dock secured and a slow response by the Alamo chapter to our advances, it seems that we will seize the Alamo very soon. With the capital and several other important settlements under Cubiclave control, the only notable places left are Nixontown, Armstrong, and the Corpse. Facing two fronts, the Alamo chapter was overwhelmed, and so we find ourselves in a peace conference. This time around, we are going to annex some land for our nation instead of making a new puppet state. You know, only in the Fallout universe it would make sense that the remnants of the United States federal government based out of Cuba and the AI of a long-dead Mexican dictator could fight a group of glorified power armor-wearing technology hoarders. Controlling more of the Texas coastline would be nice, so we are going to invade the Houston Rockets. One of our divisions land near Houston via boat, and besides that, I may have made a miscalculation in choosing to defend Richmond, mainly because we don't have any way of supplying it. Pushing in from the east, we are trying to rescue one of our units that got encircled, but other than that, I'd say overall, this war is going well. We have reached the outskirts of Houston. The Cubaclave is one province, or maybe two, away from victory. We won, and all the Rocket's land was integrated into the Cubaclave's domain. The Enclave, and by extension Cuba, which is an interesting combination, has done well for itself by establishing a presence in former Texas and Louisiana, and all of it appears to be led by someone who doesn't really care to be here. The video is going to end here. If you enjoyed the mod, check it out in the description below. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to like and subscribe. Don't forget to leave a comment because it helps the algorithm recommend the video more. Have an awesome day. I'll see y'all later. Bye.